Come on. Well, good morning, curling fans, and welcome to the B qualifier of the ATB Okotoks Classic. Our feature game this morning is Team Hardy versus Team Thomas. And we're pretty excited to be joined by the ATB Classic Banff Champions coach, Heather Rogers. Welcome to the show.
Morning, Mike.
Morning. So what you might notice out here today is the players could possibly wear masks. Alberta Curling has come up with new guidelines here as of yesterday that the players are requested to wear masks on the ice. It is not mandatory. It is a request. They are allowed to remove them while sweeping, but most of the players are going to wear them during game. And what does your team think of that, Heather?
Yeah, they're happy to be on board for this protocol. We've actually practiced it once already. It makes sweeping a bit more challenging, but they're happy to just do whatever is required to keep everybody safe and healthy.
Yeah, that's the right approach for sure. And it's pretty good that you guys practiced that already. Just gives you a little advantage over maybe some of the other teams that never thought about doing that. So it is different this year, and we are definitely on board here at Okotoks to follow as many guidelines as we can. To make sure everybody stays healthy and safe, and our staff and volunteers and the curlers. We just want to continue to play, so it was good to see, and definitely no problem here to push it forward. Well, maybe a little insight on your team with this game. I know you guys came off the big victory in Banff, mm-hmm. Had a great event over there, took down some big names with Botcher and Cooey, and of course Cooey in the final. I'm pretty excited about the way your team is for this season.
Yeah, absolutely, Mike. They've put in a lot of work. It's an interesting season, and it can kind of go either way. And these guys have chosen to practice hard and play a lot of events. And, we're really happy to come out with a win in Banff for sure.
Great. Well, then those of you who don't know, Team Hardy has got a new member to the team this year, Josh Keast. Actually, his brother and sister are both members here at Okotoks. And know the family well, came from just right out of juniors, so that's a nice addition to the team.
Yeah, it's his first year of men's, and you wouldn't even know it. He's playing really well. He's a lefty, which is new for our team as well, so there's a bit of a learning curve. But again, with the extra practice and just spending more time together, they've been able to manage it really well.
Yeah, no, it's and I mean, this team, as you've seen them grow over the years for sure. I know Jeremy from Nanton, Alberta, grew up playing the junior program there, and spent lots of time in the foothills. All our fans that are watching here definitely know Jeremy and seen him grow as a curler, and we're pretty excited to see what the future holds for sure. And of course, the other team, Team Thomas, back together this year. I know you're familiar with a lot of these players. They were this team was together back at the 2012 Provincial Championship in Camrose and lost the final to Cooey that year. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, lots of experience on this team, Heather.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's funny, you know, even if these guys took a bit of a break, you can't really tell. They're back in full stride. Obviously, JD has been quite busy coaching over in Japan, and they've all still got it.
Yeah, no, and I mean, there's so much talent here. It's put the effort in and get back to practicing, and definitely a team to compete with this year for sure.
Mm-hmm.
So we got Matt Ng throwing lead here for Team Thomas, and your team puts up the center guard. Is that the normal way you guys start the first end without the hammer, unfortunately?
Yeah, I think as long as they're feeling good and the ice has been great and consistent, so yeah.
Oh, yeah, I forgot to remind you, if you're on the crew, the ice is always great, just to tell you that, but whatever. No, you can say whatever you like as long as it's positive. Yeah, we've seen different approaches. Some teams will run up and put a corner guard, and others will come in top four. And it's a little bit of battle of the angles here. I know your third, Kyler Kleibrink, is used to that after winning the doubles event here last weekend in Okotoks. Him and his partner, Chantel Broderson, they ran the event and won it. So, they kind of designed it for themselves to win, I think.
T-line!
Little bounce.
So very important to get the angles here, correct?
Right through it.
Yeah, absolutely. We're not going to have any lack of rocks in play with these two skips.
Oh, I love it. Love it.
Close. No. Chop.
All right. 14 feet.
Okay.
Great start there. So it was just natural to throw Josh in at second and keep your other players where they were. Was there any discussion to change the lineup the way it was? Bring Josh in?
Yeah, it's close.
Yeah, you always
wait, good.
Could.
Wide only.
And I think everyone
little
was open to changes.
Back four, back eight.
If that seemed like our best fit, but...
it's real heavy.
Yeah, Kurt has played lead and second before, so we could have made a switch there, but Josh, you'll see how hard he can throw it, and you'll know why he's playing second.
There you go. And I know you guys have another coach we had commentating last weekend here at the doubles. Shannon is taking the weekend off. Shannon, I'm sure she's watching the live stream, though.
She's not at all taking the weekend off, actually. She's doing our stats from home.
Oh.
That's the beauty of the technology, and these guys stream their games on Facebook when they're not on your feature sheet. And so, yeah, we have them mic'd up, and Shannon can do everything she needs to do from the safety of her home.
Oh, there you go.
Mm-hmm.
Morning,
top
Shannon.
Four.
I'm sure you're watching.
We're tee. Hard to get it by Kurt.
That's some great sweeping by Kurt and Kyler there.
Might be a hair of a pig. Yeah.
We were talking about that yesterday. Sometimes the teams were trying to pick up, or they talk about the rocks a lot when they're throwing. And for us here at Oak Dokes, and me as the ice maker here, I'm trying to find some consistency when they tell me there's a pig. But it seems like every team there's a little different. So I'm not sure if it's the rocks or user error a lot of the time.
Yeah.
If it was something consistent, we could make some changes. But so we'll keep an eye on that today, see if we can find.
Wow.
Well, there you go. We're just a reminder that we don't have a 10-second delay here. And the players do forget they're mic'd up.
Yeah. So we just, what, overswept it? Yeah.
So maybe let our viewers know some of the challenges as dealing with a lefty compared to four righties last year.
Yeah, fortunately for us, actually, before joining our team, Josh had spent a lot of time working with Mark Kennedy, the greatest left-handed curler ever. So he was able to teach Josh a lot of tools. You want to try to throw as closely as your right-handed teammates as possible. Because otherwise the path that the rock takes traveling down the ice is going to be different, even if we put the broom in the same spot.
Yeah, it's all about rock position when you're setting up at, in the hack for sure. I know we heard Kevin Martin and Mark talk about that for years. They worked on that to try and get Mark as close to a righty as possible. And it takes a lot of work, but can be done for sure.
Hard, you got it. Hard, you got it. Hard, you got it. Hurry. Hurry.
Just rubbed on that guard a little bit. Maybe could have let that rack a little bit harder and rolled in behind the corner. But ended up sitting in the house. Hardy's going to stay on the offense here. It's really hard to defend the five-rock rule, Heather, these days. Does your team kind of look at it like we need to generate offense and not worry as much about defense with the five-rock rule?
Yeah, I mean, you have to be able to make that double or triple peel at second for sure. I'd say that's the biggest differentiator. But then, yeah, when you're defending a lead, you can't just assume the other team will blank it out or force as easily.
Hi, Josh. Whoa. Yep. Yep. Good sweep. Try and get it hair low. Hair center line side. Right side kick.
Well, Thomas doesn't recognize this is not a great position to be in, so he's going to try and play some kind of run back here and get the one off the button. And got a little bit lucky, seeing that rock hit the corner and rolled into the rings. So Hardy's definitely going to recognize that and keep an eye on it a little later. As you can hear, J.D. Lynn the second for Team Thomas recognize if they ever get a chance for a double, that brings those rocks into play.
Mm-hmm. Okay, a bit, Kurt. Line's good.
So Heather, being the daughter of Brenda Rogers, the famous official out there, I'm sure you guys have lots of discussion about the rules and. If we have any questions, I'm sure you're the one to talk to.
I at least have her on speed dial when I need help, that's for sure.
I'm sure Brenda's at home watching as well.
I'm sure she is. She's a big fan of Team Hardy.
Sweet boys.
Get that? Another executed guard perfectly.
Yeah.
You got her, bud.
It's almost not as easy as it looks out here. These players are making it good, look real easy, but when the ice is this swingy, those guards are not as easy as seem to be right now.
Definitely not. Guard placement is probably an underappreciated skill in our sport, and even Team Thomas thinks it's high enough that they can get around that.
Yeah, you can't be too high because definitely with the amount of curl, you can get to the nose here for sure. A great sweep, and there you go.
Maddie, go.
As you can tell, that guard was just a little high, and then Team Thomas was able to get to the rock that was sitting on the top of the button. Now they got to be really careful. Again, those two yellows are kicking around over there in the 12 foot.
All I see is normal and kind of roll there. Yeah. Might set up a double to sit three.
Yeah.
Or board and just hit it thin.
I don't know if we can get a board thin.
Like the board's going to hit here, right? Or half even. Biggest thing is
normal,
leaving the double.
Well, yeah, so roll. Yeah. Some control. We can stay.
Can we stick?
Yeah, try and stay there. I think so.
Is it possible?
I think with normal.
Okay. Got it.
And those of you viewers that have been watching the scores on Curling Zone, there have been a couple little changes made this morning. They are being fixed. So thanks, Jerry Gertz, for making those adjustments. But we will go around the sheets here to give an update to all the games here shortly. We have four games on the ice this morning. We're getting closer and closer to the playoffs here. So the pressure is starting to build for some of these teams. Well, what was the decision here, Heather?
Yeah, it just shows how much respect you have for the other team. They want to be really careful about where Jeremy's shooter ends up here, as not to leave Charlie a double here. So I think they're going to flip just behind the center.
Close, yep! Hard! Hard, Kurt! Hard, Kurt! Keep going!
Oh. Might have got a little fortunate there moving a red into the rings. Would have been nice a little bit deeper, but now there's a double to sit four. Yeah, those holes are, with the amount of curl we're getting out here, those holes are a little harder to navigate for sure.
Yeah, we've seen a few over curls in this first end.
Yeah, like we're just nosing, eh?
Well, we're gonna try to do this. Buck that 4 inches.
Yeah, but if we roll out, that's his only out, right?
Yeah, I'm saying definitely want to make sure I at least know.
Like hit for and we'll sweep it and make this.
Because even if we nose, if he makes his double, we'll have an easy double for three.
Sweep for the double, but...
Yeah, we just make sure we're not missing it high.
There you go. They're recognizing that again. You talked about that respect factor,
okay,
but they're gonna make sure they. If they do leave him something, that they will have a double back to score their 3 points. So,
I think
the only hope for Hardy is going to be maybe to hit and roll frozen. They might consider freezing one in there and giving up the two. We'll see where this rock ends up. Not taking a lot of ice here, so. We know it will curl.
Yeah, it's good. Good shot. Yeah. Nice, Charlie. That's good.
I'll try and roll there.
Yeah.
Peel?
Yeah.
You got it.
Half.
Little less than half.
Yeah.
Or half makes it still.
Yeah.
You got it.
Well, they're trying the double and roll up behind the corner here a little bit. Now, we know Jeremy's got all the shots in the bag, that's for sure. This will be close here. So being the coach for Team Hardy, when Jeremy's thrown his last shot, what are the things that he likes to hear in the hack from his front end?
You know, they're all pretty laid-back guys. No, nothing too particular, and nothing really seems to throw them off. I think some words of encouragement is always a good thing, and just let them make it.
Just like that. Well, there you go. Needed to hit it maybe a little thicker to spin up.
Yeah.
But so he has left the double for three. Not easy, though. Thinner than people think here. And anything thick might go over the top, but we'll see. Of course, big thanks to our production crew here working hard beside me.
Peel.
Of course, we got the master over there, Gruno, the producer. Belt note orders to everybody. I love it. Including us, unfortunately. A big shot here. Got a little full on this. And there you go. Double for three. Not quite the start Team Hardy wanted, but it's a long game. So if you're going to give up three, the first end is probably the right end to do it in.
Get our deuce.
Yeah. He's a deuce.
Blake is okay.
Yeah.
Blake's going to go super hard for two right away.
Yeah.
They had a great conversation after that. They can. What's their plan now moving forward there, Heather?
Yeah, but listening to the Hogline meetings is some of my favorite part of this being mic'd up.
I thought it was a cutter.
Yeah.
Cutter and slow. Sure, if you don't want it, we can switch sets completely.
Sure.
Mine are good.
Just talking about rocks a little bit still, and I think go for a safety.
I thought we had some good shots that end. Just pretty unfortunate. Maybe next time we blank it out. Just seems to happen. Unlucky.
Yeah, it was just unlucky.
Yeah.
There's one in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, great conversation there. They didn't play a bad
end. Your first
one
took off, but we could never predict that. Like, it curled
the
foot.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, even my heel ended up curling the foot.
Quite a bit, yeah. Yeah. Oh, well, let's get it this end. Yep.
Yeah. I go get chances.
Yep.
Okay, well, we're going to start the second end. You'll probably see Team Thomas go in top four here, knowing they're giving a three-point lead. And then I'm sure we'll see Hardy throw up a corner guard in the second end here just to try and generate a deuce. They don't have to get it all back in one end.
Okay.
Well, just a little light than they wanted, but that's okay. They're happy with the center guard.
All right, Maddie.
You got it, Kurt.
Throw in the three.
You got it.
Yeah, Kyler playing on this sheet last week might have recognized that rock would be a little bit of a cutter compared to the other two, but the rocks have all been enhanced since last weekend,
good
so
two.
Definitely changes them up quite a bit.
Yeah, and that's the beauty of pregame practice is you should have time to see some of those.
Nice shot, Kurt. Okay.
There you go, perfect. Great execution there. So you're going to see Thomas play the intern around the center line guard. We try and tell teams, you know, younger teams that got to make sure you play this turn. One, you know the turn. Two, if you do happen to poke it out, you're You're poking it out probably on the side that they can't play the hit and roll behind the corner. So. Yeah, great sweeping.
Mm-hmm.
You'll see a lot of sweeping when you get icy curls this much, that's for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. And
do you like
you
the
can hear them huffing and puffing through
the
mask,
the
but it doesn't seem to hold
back
them back.
Line?
No,
yeah.
Exactly.
You got it, Kurt. Hair slow, hair curly.
This would be one of the big changes with the five rock rule, Mike, is you're down three and you're playing a chap on the center line guard.
It's back line.
Yeah, just trying to bump it in the rings and maybe roll in behind the corner. Looks real close here.
Keep it out, keep it out. It's fine. Nice shot.
Great throw, great throw. There you go, you got your two corner guards. And with the five rock rule, of course, Team Thomas cannot peel those guards yet, so they have to stay on the offense right now.
Line's good, line's good. Line's good. Line's good. Wait only. Line's good.
This rock is about 2 feet left to the center line, and they still think it's going to get all the way over to the middle. Pretty close, but you know, we did talk earlier, they did leave the wrong side open here, so there's a chance to hit and roll in behind the corner.
This is where having a lefty never hurts either, Mike.
Yeah, you're sitting right behind the sheet, Heather. You can tell that the lefty can see a little more of the rock than a righty could.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hard.
I like the weight selection here. They're taking the weight down a bit, because if they do happen to rub on the front one, they can still roll in behind the corner. But
that's my bad. Sorry. Shouldn't call you on. I just thought it was a bit down. Yeah.
Such great teammates out there, eh? They take ownership on a lot of stuff. That really goes a long way when you're building an elite team, that's for sure.
Yeah, hit and roll.
Kyler recognized that he might have jumped the sweep and thought the weight was down a little bit.
Yeah, let's try and roll as far as we can.
Well, with that little bit of a rollout that Team Thomas can run up and peel some guards now.
Hard! Hard! Hard, Maddie! What? Brock! Brock!
Well, Team Thomas has showed up ready to play this morning. They are not missing much right now.
No, they're not.
Yeah.
This is the second time we've seen Thomas on the live stream, and
firm, you got it.
As you can tell, they're getting better as the event goes on here, and again, this is probably their first event of the year, and you know, it does take a few games to get more, even though they played lots in the past, it does take a few games to get familiar with each other and get your sea legs under you, but you can say they're warming up now. They're definitely getting better, that's for sure.
Yeah, I was talking to JD a little bit before the game, and he said they're only playing three events this season and then playdowns.
Well, that's not a big schedule compared to Team Hardy's playing. What's the schedule for Team Hardy right now?
Yeah, we'll be at about eight events. This is our third, and then after this they have Penticton, Calgary, Red Deer, and Medicine Hat.
Great.
Clean, clean.
Yeah, no. Neither way is right or wrong. It's kind of what your commitment level is. You know, family life gets in the way, work gets in the way,
we're
a lot of things.
And
all these players have regular jobs. They're not doing as professionals, but you know, sometimes it's just availability to get together. I'm sure Thomas and them are practicing a lot on their own, but I know
just
Virtue's
firm
from Lethbridge, and
Little roll under.
The other three guys are from Calgary, and I think they are playing at the Calgary Curling Club, I heard, but still not quite the same as playing this high-level competition that they're getting in these events.
Whoa. Kurt, hard, Kurt.
Well, and we know Kyler's actually on the double scene as well, so he's curling a lot this year.
He is, yeah. His work allows for it, and he, you know, it's a busy schedule,
and
he's got the support of his family and his girlfriend, and it's fantastic to see.
Yeah, it's people don't realize it. At the stage they're at, really trying to break through to the next level, and just on the brink of getting invited to go to those bigger slam events, and you know they're getting to the age where careers are starting and families are starting, and it's just not easy sometimes to balance that whole situation.
No, definitely not.
And I know, Heather, you've been coaching some a little bit on the ladies' scene, and that's even tougher sometimes on the ladies' side.
What do you like?
Well, it can be for sure. I mean, you do see a lot of fantastic athletes go out there and play quite pregnant, and that's incredible to see. But yeah, absolutely.
Even if we were like,
and of course, next weekend we are going to have the ladies' event here in Okotoks, which we've got a few teams you might have heard of. We're pretty excited to have teams like last year's Alberta champ Laura Walker and Casey Scheidegger. And we have, which Laura Walker's team will be skipped by Cheryl Bernard. I'm sure some of you have heard her name before. And of course, the likes of last year's Scottish champ Carrie Anderson, Rachel Holman, Jennifer Jones.
Yeah, but
I don't know if I'm even missing anybody in the
Kelsey
country.
Rock?
Kelsey Rock, that's right. Holy smokes, I can't even. There's so many good teams, I can't even keep track.
It's going to be fantastic. I'll be tuning into that live stream for sure.
There you go. We got another viewer, guys.
So you
thumbs up from the crew.
You were just light, I think, right? Yeah. Okay, you got it.
And we are telling everybody to subscribe to the Okotoks Curling Club YouTube page. If you want to get the updates of the games that are coming, or when they show up, you definitely subscribe. There's no charge for that. And we're just trying to get ahead of Banff on their subscribers. I know Steve's watching out there.
Come on, Katie. Go. Come on. Go, Jamie, go. Go.
Yeah, okay.
Maybe just a little light on that one. Left another a little opening here for Hardy. They got a chance to hit over here and roll in behind cover. Those two yellows are there to be advanced forward as the end goes on, but.
Yep. Whoa. Kurt. Hi, Kurt. Kate, whoa.
That one didn't quite curl as much as they expected.
Not moving.
Yeah, you're right. They've undercurled a bunch for sure.
Here you go. They might have got caught in the first end on just some fresh pebble, and now she's broken down a little bit. She'll track a little straighter.
Yeah, they definitely
longer, and then finish at the end. But they haven't, caught. Hardy's team has quite a positive release that they probably work on.
They do, and I just overheard JD and Matt talking about that as well. Of course,
definitely getting a little straighter. So.
Yeah, of course, JD can see these things too, but he's saying that Hardy's rocks are running just a little straighter than Team Thomas.
Yeah, and that's teams, we talk about with the juniors and other teams to try and work on that positive release, so when they get out here, being able to play on ice like this with this swingy, and other teams that don't work on that, they just struggle a little bit with some overcurls.
Yeah, absolutely. You can only do so much with the sweep, and it's important to, get that line of delivery and that nice crisp release.
Yeah, and you know what? A lot of these teams, they play on, when they play on the arena events, they seem to get a lot of curl, and they got to be prepared for that. So we try to provide that kind of ice here as close as we can to an arena without being in an arena, and the teams that are playing the best on the weekend will definitely be there in the finals.
Just hit him blank.
So they did talk earlier in the end that, a blank was fine here. I know in the between-end conversation. They didn't have to go extremely hard for the deuce, so.
The button here?
Yeah, that'll be tight.
I like the reassurance from the teammates to remember that, you know, Blank is still okay. Kyler reminded Jeremy. But Jeremy does recognize that if he doesn't roll into the rings, that they will come around the center guard.
We thought about it, but then we think he...
My only concern is if we're here, he plays the run back and we're forced to, right? This always brings a Blank in, doesn't it?
True.
But if we are here, he stays out of the rings, right?
Yeah,
if he
but
hits.
He'll stick buried if
but
he runs.
Stick buried, right?
One of them.
I don't mind it. It's just, I mean, if he makes it perfect, he'll get forced. I guess
if he makes either shot perfect, Unless we rip both, but then he still just comes around and forces.
I'm good either way. I just thought, I didn't know if he was talking about this or not. Yeah, we did.
Just, well, even if we stick, he could hit it, and then we got our Blank.
Yeah,
I think the worst is buried, because then he has to do this.
Got to be in, right?
Yeah, it's kind of tough to...
I don't know if you can roll here and be in.
Yeah.
I think the rest is staying around, though.
Yeah.
Great conversation with the team there.
We have to go a bit wider, so.
Looked at all angles, all options.
Okay. At least it's their practice line.
Yeah.
Okay. I think you would have cleared the guard a button, so.
Yeah.
So they decided on the come around here. What do you think of this call there, Coach?
Yeah, I'm happy with it. I mean, you want to leave it high enough that when Charlie makes the run back, you can still draw for your one.
That's right. Yeah, and I like that comment when he makes the run back. You got to play that, assume that he's going to make his shot perfectly. If you sit here and expect to miss, you're definitely playing in the wrong field, that's for sure.
Absolutely, and I think that's why they spent so much time talking about it is, again, you expect a team like Charlie or anyone here to make a shot like that.
Looks hot! Right off! Right off! Close, Kurtz! Kurtz!
Now they're trying to make a curl here.
Go back, yep. Kurt. Yep, go. Go, hard. Keep going.
Well, they are buried. Now Thomas has a chance to fall him down, go top four here. They won't freeze. They know they've got a chance to steal here if they go around top button. But that little red over there on just short of the rings might come into play here on the last one if he makes a perfect come around here.
Yeah, because you threw this. You threw it pretty light? Yeah, because out of your hand it looked light. Okay. Yeah, it's full speed.
Notice every line is a team, every shot is a team shot.
The
front end has to know all the paths and understanding the speed in this area. And so they're pretty confident this is up to speed right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's pretty good. Wide only. All there.
I know he knows his tolerance here is definitely be a little deeper.
Weight's pretty good. Back eight. Back eight. Back four.
Right on it.
You're right on it. Just let it
die.
Nice, Charlie.
Played the freeze back down there.
Yeah, no, honestly,
so just a reminder, viewers, they are masked today. Just because Curling Alberta has released guidelines that masks are requested to be worn on ice today. It's not a mandatory thing. It's a request that the guidelines for Curling Alberta has changed. As of yesterday, sent out the email, and most of these teams want to follow along with the request. Again, they're just trying to keep everybody safe and make sure they stay able to curl.
Josh's rock. Hard. Wait only. Touch blue. Wait only. Just touch blue. Nice shot. 15-1. Sweep.
There you go. Got their one. Great, great come around there. Not quite what they wanted, but on the scoreboard.
Yeah, absolutely. Probably mission accomplished there for Team Thomas, but good for Jeremy to have a nice draw to the button there.
Yeah, just make sure we score too, you know, like, let's not give him any life here. Like, two is always good, but I'd say our defense is pretty good, so even if we just take ones, you know, like, keep that lead.
There you go, heard from Team Thomas at the end. Their goal is to at least, if they get a deuce, great, but they just want to make, they want to score when they're up two. Hardy's going to try and steal here or force the one and get the hammer back.
Cuba?
Yeah,
I thought it was the American flag. I was like, what's going on here? And I was like, no, that's it's Cuba.
We're wearing fishing down there.
That's right. Yeah.
Run your broom on its own. On its own. Right on your broom.
Chuck, Kurt.
Center line guard, perfect there. So Team Thomas, it's important to stay above the T line here, that's for sure. They want to go top 12, top button, or top four, top button here. Anything behind the T line will be an advantage for Team Hardy. These are important shots when you're, even when you're ahead, these are important shots for each team, Heather.
Yeah, absolutely. I would even say,
pretty close.
You know, full eight here would be a nice shot, Mike.
Yeah, anything but a guard or behind the tee line is probably the best scenario.
All right, Maddie, shot. Yeah.
You got it. Right to it.
Do it.
Little heavy.
Little bounce. Just do it. Little bounce.
Gotta go a little bit here for line, it looks like.
Bouncing.
Trying to get right to the face. Yeah, great drill. I'd say perfect. We'd be happy with that, coach.
Yeah, you bet. I'm sure Shannon gave that a 4 out of 4.
How serious does your team look at the stats? We talked yesterday with John Dunn, coach for Team Cooey, and they, you know, they respect the stats out there, but they don't focus on them for sure. And we know some teams do focus on the stats. I mean, when you're dealing with the U of A program and Mr. Rob Krebs, he's big on analytics and understanding the stats. And but how does your team view it?
Yeah, I think it helps, first of all, that we do the stats internally. So with Shannon always taking our stats, then we have some consistent numbers. And then we can build our practices around that, too. So we don't talk about the stats between games or even necessarily after every event in terms of percentages. We're just looking for trends and areas we can improve on.
Yeah, that makes sense. So if someone's constantly throwing an intern tight or missing their intern lots, you can work on that.
There you go, yeah.
Good board. Like me. It's good,
well,
Josh.
They figured out that side of the sheet.
Yeah, they're making everything over here now. And they're showing lots of patience here. They, you know, they'll probably end up seeing a few rocks removed here. And they're hoping at the end they do have that center guard can come around and maybe force or even get a steal or get two reds in the house and force that way. But Thomas, of course, being up 3-1 is...
Hard.
A little bit of a mistake there, obviously. It didn't seem like they were quite ready to sweep that one.
Yeah.
The line was called earlier, and little delay might have cost them a couple inches there. Once it starts to curl, you're not going to stop it, so you got to just anticipate it's going to curl.
Probably just
sure.
A two, hey? Otherwise, the run back's easy.
Late two.
Find a room. Okay, guys, get her going. Okay, you gotta get her going.
A little heavy.
Well, I suspect we're gonna see some granite moving here.
I think we will, Mike. And he just threw it, so I think he's going to be pretty darn close.
Yeah, they'll recognize this spot's going to curl a little more than they expected.
Hard.
Whoa. Yep. Well, got a couple reds moved, but left the center guard, so not exactly what they planned there for sure.
I don't mind if they hack and roll that way. I think that's too easy. Right on the UR or URL. Just the 1-2.
Just gonna put a guard back up there, coach. Okay.
Yeah, the higher the better, really. You're not going to see Team Thomas draw here, so make their run back as difficult as possible.
Okay.
Yeah, you're probably going to see them run their own yellow in there, especially if this is being high. So kind of cover half and half here. It's hard to take both away, but.
Whoa, got room. Room. Whoa. Right off.
It's probably got to stop.
Sweep.
Okay, well, they guarded the one rock.
Overcurl there.
Just a little bit of an overcurl there. They did talk about, there you go. Did its job, and they're playing the run back here. All three guards gone.
Yeah, perfect shot there.
Shot.
Pick one to guard.
Yeah.
Same spot, a little deeper. Basically same weight, just clean it. Mine's good. Wolf, you can. Mine's good, yep. Hard, boys. Hard. Keep going, Josh. Keep going. Keep it moving. Hard.
Well, might have left the double. Well, we're sitting right behind the sheet. They can see a little more of that.
Yeah.
Probably see about half of that rock or maybe three quarters from the hack.
Yeah, probably closer to three quarters.
So the double is there. I guess the key is to keep the shooter around for Team Thomas because if they roll out, you'll see Hardy come around that center.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there you go. You got it.
Heavy control.
My curl of hair here, so just be ready, Maddie. Hard.
Gotta go hard here.
You got it, you got it. You got it, you got it, you got it. Yeah, that's good, Brock.
Well, got the one. Didn't quite get the double they were hoping, but did keep the shooter around, so Hardy's going to have to do something with that shooter.
Yeah, four? Yeah. I thought he turned his in and they held it, so I don't think it's going to go a mile. You got it.
There you go. They're recognizing the releases a little bit.
No, it's worse.
It's very important. All the teams are always watching the other team's throw as well.
But the perfect
just so they know why the rock did what it did.
Christmas tree. But that's good, too.
So they're trying a little hit and roll here just to get in behind the center guard. This rock that they're throwing now could end up being the force point, Heather.
It could, absolutely. You'd love to see that little bit of over roll, as Kyler indicated, just because if you dead bury this, Mike, though, you'll see Thomas hit and roll off of the one on the side of the forefoot.
Yeah, if they can just overbury a little bit and just not quite show Teed Thomas the full red on the top of the four, they'll have to hit that and then they'll roll to the outside.
Yep, yep, yes! Hard, Josh! Hard! Whoa!
Oh, maybe. Great roll in behind, but didn't quite get that over roll like you wanted. Maybe just jumped it a little bit?
Yeah. Seems to be a spot that they expect to see a little curl, but...
Unless the ultimate goal is to get dead behind it. I mean, they are completely buried behind that center guard. But there is a slight out here. If Thomas gets a roll under both of those, he'll use that one top eight as a guard.
Absolutely.
So this is the B qualifier here at the Okotoks Curling Club for the ATB Classic. A big thanks to our sponsor, ATB. When these guys stand behind the sheet, can't see nothing. That's why we got our great broadcast crew here. We can watch the action live on the screen, just like you are at home. Real close. Oh, just not quite under. Well.
Bite the eight. He'll probably hit, but that's fine too.
Yeah.
They can hit this yellow, but the ultimate goal, I know they talk about sitting around the eight, but as long as that yellow goes, they've probably done their job and forced Thomas into a draw. I don't think you'll see Thomas if they don't run back trying to blank it, but maybe.
I don't,
so
yeah.
Stick around over at the 12 foot. That's their goal right now. Here for line.
Hard! Whoa!
Well, they got it. Are they going to stick around?
Stop.
Oh, excellent throw. Well, did their job. Forced Thomas in the draw for one.
Yeah, absolutely. I think sticking there in the men's game is so important too, Mike. I'm not as certain of Team Thomas's strategy here, but if you're playing a team like Cooey, you know he's going to run up there and make the run.
So this
for the
this
blank.
Side, you threw this.
Yeah, they're going to play the run double for sure because they know they're up 3-1 and want to keep control of the hammer.
He threw last in. Yeah, because this turn might curl his hair more, so it might take a little off.
Great communication there by the front end.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have to say I love that JD Lind is mic'd up here. It's fantastic to hear. He has a wealth of information and experience, and
pretty good.
It's great to be able to listen in on him.
Got a lot right now. I think it's pretty good. Gotta go.
Got a goal here for Wade. Might have been a little outside the line they wanted. They're really working this hard. Got a goal to get by.
Nice.
Just got it there. Great sweeping by the front end.
So I really think that turn has quite a bit more curl, and everything's just heavier there. Because even your board weight hit.
There you go.
And then your in turn that end, like they both didn't really curl.
Good one.
Yeah, we thought heavy out of it.
Yeah.
Yep. We all thought heavy. Yeah.
Started curling early.
But based
my,
on.
Well, my two though, like this one curled a lot more than this one.
But your first on that end looked the same. About halfway down, I was like, we got to go. But I think that's with the out turn, that same weight would have been perfect.
Yeah. Yep, that side might have just a little bit more curl and takes a couple feet off.
Yeah. Like even our guards
they can see, if you're looking at the ice from here, you can see that the left side is a little more shiny than the right. Yeah. They probably played the left a little bit more, polished it up.
Depends how tight they are.
I think we're getting pretty late in the game. Maybe double.
Corner,
one and a chop or two.
I think they'll probably go in, so.
So in this strategy, you think they're gonna go? Your team is talking about double corner. Or?
So probably double corns.
There you go. I guess we don't have to ask you. Just let them tell us.
If you get two, the odds come back a bit.
Yeah. Yeah, the two one. Tight guard right now.
Gotta go. Oh, we're going guard? A guard?
Change of last. We still got to go for a bit.
No, we're good. We're good for guard. I thought we were going in.
I thought the call was in. Call was in, right?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. All right, Matt.
Well, the call was in, but Charlie recognized that they were sweeping a lot, so decided to come up short. They probably could have got that in the rings, though, if they had kept sweeping.
Good two.
Just two. Two, three.
So I know, for sure Team Cooey's at home listening. Does your team prefer one corner guard over the other?
No, fortunately
really
for us, Curtis has both turns. I think, they're okay with either.
Good.
Either side. Now, the other question we had yesterday was, do you prefer corner on each side or do you do two on the same side?
So it does depend on the weight and the speed of the first corner, but I think optimally you'd put two on one side and call those stacked corners. Unless, of course, it's a halfway guard, and then you're forced to split the corners and go to the other side.
Yeah, right now. We can wait, though.
There you go. Every team does things a little bit different, so they'll...
Wait, kid.
Ideally, they'd love to have two on the same side, but
it's all there.
Situation, you're probably going to see them spread them out.
Yeah, go.
Leave it, then?
Yeah. Definitely looked like a lot more positive out of his hands. All right, Maddie.
Amazing that the release makes such a difference there. You can tell he was more positive release, and that rock tracked a lot straighter and definitely a lot quicker down the ice.
Freeze isn't looking bad either.
I'm good either way. Whatever you like, Jer. Okay.
Yeah, I like that.
It's a good speed over here, okay?
Yeah, it's pretty nice.
So because that rock slipped behind the T line there, they're going to take advantage of it early and throw one in frozen on top. It does reduce the scoring area a little bit going around the center here, but.
Top four.
They'll be able to use they're hoping they can use their corner guard a little bit later.
Top 12. Top eight. Oh, no. Did sail a long way.
think so. And I won't be super stiff.
Just a little light on that?
Yeah. I was trying to listen in and see what they thought there, but yeah, they called a 15-6 and swept it to top 12.
15-6, that's definitely, we've been seeing 14-7s, 14-6s. So that's definitely a little lighter, but you can notice that here that sweeping is making a huge difference to the weight. If they're a little light, you can drag it a long way.
Oh, especially these guys.
Yeah, I just throw that intern tight.
Yeah, absolutely, they're so strong.
Yeah. Yeah, just
conditioning's
like a
probably
tight.
A big part of your team
yeah.
as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And to be honest, Mike, I think youth is on their side as well. But absolutely, they're all in the gym, and especially you know they have a longer off season this year, so a lot of rehab in their bodies and rest and recovery.
There you go.
Top four. That's great.
Well, they're taking the opportunity to use their corner guard now. The rock just slid behind the tee line. Got to go to get second shot here.
I think it's this.
I don't know.
Maybe just lost the line a little bit at the end. We're missing dead-eye Deb McLaren to tell us who's going to step up on the crew to tell us who shot there. They're all looking at each other, pointing to each other. Nope, no takers. Heather, what do you think?
Well, I'm going to trust Charlie here. He thinks it's red.
We could maybe come around and just nudge it too.
Well, you know your reputation's on the line here, Heather.
Okay.
Just no pressure, but
red second.
We hold teams. We hold people accountable. Well, that angle really looks like red from here.
We just freeze through it.
What a great job by the crew.
Yeah, we just freeze through it. You like?
I'm saying red too.
Okay.
Except you said it first, so it's not really my reputation if it's wrong.
No, and I'm basing it off of Charlie. So.
Okay. Well, what do you think the conversation's going to be here? Let's listen in.
Like, we could just follow him down and just nudge him sideways.
Yeah, I'm thinking that. I mean, it's not like a gimme shot, but yeah.
No.
What does he do if we peel the corner?
Wow.
He's probably coming around the center, and then it's all in the rims and blasting.
Yeah, it's kind of conceding, too, a little.
Really?
Well, like, I think he just comes around the center, doesn't he?
Sort of a high guard.
And force him to draw around. Well, what if we just come top four?
Well, I was thinking that, but he's definitely going to play a double around, and then we're playing all around the corner. So.
Yeah.
Then, like, the tick shot isn't really very good.
My problem is he might be able to just come around, like, even if we're, like, over here, he might be able to just come around and with back line and move that, but.
Yeah, I don't like the guard.
Then we just come around both of them.
But. Yeah. No, you're right.
I think we either come around top four.
Mike, my first thought was just to nudge it.
I think top four peeled the corner.
So if you're Team Hardy, what do you want them to do here?
Probably leave them a triple.
Other than flash or something like that, which we know is not going to happen.
Well, yeah, okay.
I know, you know, JD seems confident to chase around the corner there.
So you think we peel, so we peel this, right? So we...
Probably.
We don't have a shot off either, right? We still got that yellow in the way.
If he comes around our yellow.
Yeah.
And then, so you peel that. He comes around our yellow. I peel that one out.
Yeah, he comes around again. And then you got a.
And you got a 4 foot.
Well, right. The problem is, yeah, but we got that rock that we could jam onto.
From here, Mike, that red is overburied. And I know if JD thinks he can make it, then that's fantastic. I think I'd be playing.
Yeah,
I get
the really high guard. Like, I don't think that shot that hard.
So we got a comment. The Team Thomas wins the Best Team Shirts Awards. You know what? That's the second time I heard that this weekend, that they really love the color and the design. So I don't know who we owe that credit to, but.
Well, Dynasty for sure would have been part
exactly,
of the design process.
Definitely Dynasty on the shoulders there.
Yeah.
So.
Back line. And if we're a little tight and we chip the guard, we might spill in the house anyway, right? Okay.
Now, you haven't seen all the shirts this weekend, so we'll give them a couple votes for now. But there's some great ones out there.
It's good.
Yep. Yep. Oh.
Great sweeping to get it by that corner guard. But.
Good sweep.
And did roll in to sit second. But I think they can pretty much get to that and sit second and third.
Yeah, they can't really hit and roll off that one.
We might have to. Who's third shot, guys? Anybody?
You're thinking roll behind?
There we go. We're going to have a look again. Oh, this is close.
Okay. Is it too tough, though?
It might be a double and roll either way, Mike.
There you go.
Okay, let's make it.
Still not going with a count. I'm still not making a prediction.
Yeah,
there,
as long as they make the double here, then we won't have to.
Perfect.
What kind of weight?
Don't want to put us on the spot.
Board,
so.
Control. Okay. You got it, Josh. Good control.
Control.
Hanging a little bit. Could play the thin double the other way. Oh, it's real close.
Nice shot, Josh. Beauty.
And one of the new rules out there due to COVID is you can't sweep those rocks behind the tee line. So it's real hard for these teams to sit and watch that yellow just kind of trickle to the back four and not be able to sweep it. But that red is dead buried.
Half in the four.
So they're sitting shot and fourth shot right now. And you're going to see Team Thomas. Brock Richard's going to throw this one, try and freeze onto that one in the top four.
Yeah.
It's pretty close. Weight's good.
Gotta go.
Going for weight here.
Gotta go.
Line looks pretty good.
Go. Come on. Easy. Yeah, shot, Brock.
Well, they recognize it wasn't going to quite get frozen to that red, and they want to be able to use it later, so they just stopped to leave
it under our
top
red.
Eight, and they can see three quarters of it, so if they ever need to use it to run in later, it is there.
Or we stack another one on. That's okay.
We will throw some updates at you right after this end. Heather, that's your job, so you can update everybody of what's going on around the rink today. We got a few seconds here. You might as well do it now.
I can move it right onto the one.
We know what color is the dilemma. We've got to wait and see what color here. But look like Sturme.
Shot is
no. They're going to put a score up there.
Oh, good.
Sturme scored 2 and 3 to go up 4-1 on Team Jake's. Then you can do that side of the sheet because I can't see that far.
Okay, we have Vavrick in the middle.
Keep it on the corner.
They're playing the fourth end.
Yep. They're yellow.
Vavrick's down two with hammer. And Glenn Kennedy is up two without playing Jacob Libis. You might be familiar with that team, Mike.
Yeah, I kind of know a couple guys on that team.
Help to just rip that.
They were pretty excited. They got their first win yesterday. They've had a lot of great close games. Just came out on the wrong side of the inch. Another team right out of juniors.
Rip it that way.
All four players out of juniors there, first year.
Probably a double. I think we rip it at that one, nose this, or freeze this and see how it goes.
That sounds like a lot of options there, Kyler.
Okay, I think rip, try and get that back yellow.
Quite an interesting end here. There's lots of conversation on both teams.
I do jam it here. At least it hits that one.
Well, both teams recognize this is a vital end when it comes. A two by Hardy would get him right back in the game. And a steal or a force by Virtue would take control back. Looks like they're going to play the double peel.
Yep. Whoa. Yep. Whoa.
Peeling the bun. Are they trying to get the one in the back as well?
They were, yeah, trying to keep three in play here.
It works, just...
Just high side.
Couldn't get him off.
Yeah, we're getting lots of comments about Team Jake's Cooey yesterday. That was a spectacular game to watch, and great commentary from their coach, John Donna. Really great. I'm actually loving having these coaches here, like you and John. Forget everybody else. I mean, we're just going to have coach take over.
When I got home last night, I zipped through some of that because somebody like me could learn a lot listening to John Dunn.
It was pretty spectacular.
It really was.
And, yeah, maybe a little bit of a letdown over there on sheet one after such a great game. But, you know, Sturmey is no slouch. I mean, you got to play every game to the top of your ability or you're going to lose because they're just all these teams are so good. Of course, Sturmey is last year's runner-up in the of the men's provincials here in Alberta, losing to Botcher in a thriller 8-end game.
What'd I miss? What'd I miss?
He flashed the guard to try to get that third shot.
Oh, yeah? Okay, so there's just one red in there? Oh, yeah, so they just peeled the guard.
Man, I think we got viewers from all over the world here.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So best thing about this streaming is these people throw in comments, eh? Sometimes. Some of the comments I really ignore, but most of the time... I actually like a lot of the comments and the questions. So if you do have a question for Team Hardy coach Heather Rogers, I'm sure she can answer anything to do with curling. Well, she said pretty much anything. And especially rules, of course. Her mother, Brenda Rogers, is like one of the top officials out there in the country.
What are we doing?
And I know she's viewing, tuning in here to watch this game. Big supporter of Team Hardy as well. And probably just because it's a curling game on. She probably watches all the streams.
Anyone you're commentating, Mike.
Whoa, there you go. I like it. Now trying to angle this into the red. Oh, just jammed it over there. Well, there's a major mistake. That changes everything a lot. They did play the angle, but it's stuck back there. So right now, Hardy has a chance to hit
and
set three.
If we draw, we got a tough one.
Yeah.
Doubles there, but tough maybe.
Yeah.
I think we. I could throw normal. Whatever you want. I like normal. Yeah. As long as we roll a bit. Yeah, roll pretty far.
The only thing they're a little worried about, these rocks are all behind the tee line, but I don't think you're going to see Thomas draw to anything being up 4-1. But
it's a catcher, but we want to just roll frozen on it.
Just trying to avoid to leave a double here.
Mm-hmm. Or just roll towards it is fine. Yeah. Yep. Yep.
I don't think it's helping. They seem to get them going. This spot we know will curl, but they're jumping them early, so they must be just getting them started a bit.
Yeah, Kyler knew exactly how he threw that one, and they've played with each other long enough.
And it's absolutely perfect. There's no doubles there for sure.
No.
That red that's on the edge of the 12 over there is half buried by a corner guard, so there's definitely no double.
Give me three.
And like you heard from Thomas himself, it's a gimme three right now. But the great thing about curling that John Dunn was saying yesterday is you have to throw every shot and things could change with every delivery.
Yeah, Brock couldn't be tight on his. Okay. Trying to roll a bit or nose? Okay.
Actually, that's comments from J.D. Lind.
Yeah.
Charlie, we got to turn his mic on. I think his mic is off. I suspect we just didn't turn it on. So Charlie, of course, two-time world junior champ.
Yeah.
I mean, definitely was coming out of juniors, was one of the hot players that everybody expected to really do a lot in the men's scene for sure. and started off great. Took a couple years off, probably with work and other issues to, you know, that get in the way of curling. And love to see him back on the ice here. So talented.
Yeah, absolutely, Mike. And him and Kalen Park had a fantastic doubles career as well together.
Yeah, let's go way back so he can't freeze.
Well, then you might have a double off.
We can freeze there.
Now here's the question. Where do I put the third rock? I would put it right back where it was. I don't think they're going to freeze.
Because he could freeze. I'm just worried of any freeze right now. I guess if we go there, he freezes.
You gotta make a perfect freeze.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, putting back it back where it was.
Yeah, I think so. Just across the center line there.
These rocks will be really spread out, so there shouldn't be any doubles.
Make sure we're deep.
We've seen a few teams, yep. A few players this end come up light in this Four. Spot here, Mike. We'll just
make sure we're deep, boys. Back 12 is okay. Yep.
Trying to get this back eight so there's no double.
Keep going.
Looks pretty close. 14-2.
Great shot.
Absolutely perfect. Now what do you do? Concede the three. Do you play the freeze here, Heather?
If you're confident in making it, it's your only way to get out of this with only two, right? Hoping Jeremy blasts and his shooter rolls
out
of play.
Make sure you throw a hit. I don't throw a draw. Make sure we're shot. See if we can get a roll out.
There you go. JD recognizes the score.
Mm-hmm.
Three is not terrible here. I mean,
especially
it's not what they wanted, but
curly turn would be nice. Okay. Yeah, just nose. Why are we throwing so much weight?
Got a roll out there. Now he's got to basically take the same path here and throw the draw for three.
Yeah. Gain a little momentum here.
Yeah, really important here for people to understand that you don't always have to throw it out there on the edge of eight and try and draw the button. Go with the path you knew. You just threw this shot. Your percentages of making this go way up.
Yeah, absolutely. And your sweepers know how to judge this rock.
Well, it's a big shot here for Team Hardy. Get right back in the game and tie this up after four ends.
Oh, yeah.
Sweeper seemed to like it. Line's good.
Shot.
This must have been on 15-something on that one. I must have missed it, Heather.
Well, the ice is pretty good, Mike.
Yeah, that's right, Heather. Good comment there.
We have to make a few.
Second rock down that path. It is pretty quick, usually.
Yeah, and like, just had a few.
We go in, they blank, though, right?
Yeah. I think we go tight one.
Tight one? Yeah.
Oh, we got a comment from Brenda. Nice and team hardy, she said.
Yeah.
You're right, she was watching.
Oh, yeah, big fan.
Yeah.
I was in a meeting the other day with her at, I won't say where, but we had a meeting about the upcoming men's provincials and ladies' provincials, and Curling Alberta will make an announcement shortly where those are going to be, so.
Okay.
Tune in to Curling Alberta's live stream, or not live stream, I guess, Facebook and Twitter, and find out all the updates in the curling world in Alberta.
Any idea who will be making the ice for those events, Mike?
I'm sure some guy that really knows what he's doing for sure. Yeah, no, we're going to be up there that week. Oh, up there. Could be down here, but during the week, myself and Brett Harkey out of Leduc, we try and do as many events as we can together, and we are planning to be there to
the other guards were harder to get over.
Try and get the ice swinging, and it seems like we can so far.
Fantastic.
When you look at it here.
Yeah, a little.
I know it is exciting this year that the men's and ladies will be held together this year due to COVID, obviously, and other things that are going on in the world. There will not be any spectators, unfortunately. But lots of live streaming. You'll be able to watch the semifinals and finals on Sportsnet, so you'll get your curling fix that week as well. Well, after four ends, we got a tie game here after a big three.
Yeah, and Charlie throwing the corner guard did surprise me a little bit here, Mike. This should be a
top four, T-line.
With lots of rocks in play.
Yeah, you'd figure he might have waited one more end to really go offense here. And this is the fifth end, and you see a lot of these teams analyze what end to put the pedal down. And surprising that the fifth end is... and that they're looking to generate lots of offense.
Yeah, I think they're ready to get the momentum back on their side.
Yeah, that's probably a great call.
Shot. Nice shot.
Is he coming around, or what do we do?
Just breathe, right?
Logged on from Mexico. Sunny and 28, just saying, they said. Yeah, well, we don't care if you're logged on. You can go back to the beach or something.
Little tap. Top eight.
No, just frozen.
Top eight.
Just frozen.
Top eight.
You can finish, JD. Cool.
T line. Little bump. 1 foot.
Pretty big bump.
Behind it.
We go around.
We're back four. Hard, Kurt, get around. Weight's pretty good.
Wow.
Good.
Just a little deep on that, trying to play a tap or.
Yeah, a little, but you know what? It's not bad for the force here.
No, exactly. Buried in the back of the eight.
John said 2-3.
What do you like?
Like, I don't like that.
So?
That's how we give up steam. Like, I think that's not good. Would you agree? Yeah, I was kind of thinking sit 2-3.
Yeah, I don't mind that either. Yeah.
Like, I just worry if we come around, like, I don't know.
Yeah, I like that. Let's do that.
Like, I guess we could keep that. Like,
board?
Let's see what they want.
You need board
here.
To get this out, right?
Yeah,
again, Mike, JD's strategy and experience here really coming into play.
No, because, like, the thing is, it's going to open up our intern,
yeah,
and he's
going
to have to hit one of them.
Great call here. It's second and third.
Like, we don't need
that
to be
rock
super
is at the back
aggressive right to start here. Yeah.
Clean, yep.
Clean.
Yep.
Whoa,
right,
whoa.
Right. Yep. Yep.
Whoa.
Like to stick around
yep
with the shooter.
Yep.
Go, Matt. It's good. Pretty good. Good shot.
Very nice, but I think they left that's the good double there.
I think they did too,
yeah,
but
opened
they've opened
up
the middle for themselves.
Got to be careful here. Don't believe they can get enough of this yellow to jam at the back.
Mike?
You got this, Josh.
Just knock on
oh
wood there.
Sorry. Not trying to jinx anybody. I'm just trying to tell the viewers at home what we can see. And he'll make this easy anyway. Just off the back, but so a little thinner than they wanted.
Okay. So yours is good here?
Yeah, that's good here.
And that's the same ice about?
Well,
yeah,
let's see if I can get a time on this one, Heather. Although this watch only ever says 15, I don't know.
Top 8.
Okay, just top 8.
Hey, line's
good.
Okay.
Line's good.
Close.
Line's good.
They like it. Sweepers
line's
like it.
Good.
We know it's going to finish hard here.
How do you hit anything?
That
line's good.
Is missing the guard
here,
by
here,
at
here
least a foot and a half.
I think you're just tee, aren't you?
Front of the tee.
Okay. It's not bad.
Yeah, 14 and a half. No sweeper.
Hair heavy, but.
Wow.
Spot's pretty quick.
My only other thought was hit and roll out here, but if you don't like that, we freeze it up.
We just can't lock it right here, right? We just gotta cross it.
Okay.
Cross as much as we can. Okay.
So they could look at the intern if they're worried about crossing
just freeze
it, but they've watched this path quite a few times. And it will curl in there. That guard is
15 or 49?
Good 2-3 feet above the top 12.
Okay, 15.
15 seconds, there you go.
Thought a little hot.
I guess my watch is right, Heather.
Whoa then, room. Room. Whoa.
I love when the players are mic'd up. You can really hear the intensity build as the game goes on in a close one. This one has to curl a long way across
Kurt,
the face.
Kurt.
It's trying. 14.75. He probably wanted to have that 15 to let it curl. Just throw it to the sweepers a little bit more.
A little bounce is good. Just freeze them.
Well, it might have did his job. I might consider playing a little bit more weight on this, try and kill that back red, but they're just trying to bump it a foot.
Hard roll. Go hard.
No.
At it.
I don't know.
Okay.
That is not the result they were looking for.
Third? Okay. I think you said third or a quarter?
I think so.
Third or a quarter?
Okay.
Yep.
Trying to play the double here and sit three.
Whoa, Josh. Hard, Josh.
pushed it just far
enough.
Just
far enough, yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah, that shot, that's the exact same path that overcurled on them earlier in the game, so definitely raking the pebble down there. It's running just a little straighter, longer there.
All right, Brock, you got it.
Well, going for the peel now. Nothing's really setting up well for them here, so they're going to try and open up the middle.
Whoa! Gam on the yellow.
Hey.
Well, one of the only advantage from that is it did roll for a corner, but we're so late in the end that they need to make some contact with these ones in the 4-footer. Gonna have a hard time scoring.
You could actually guard either thing, because that always jams, but that puts them there. Both is good.
Well, we saw Team Hardy come back against Cooey in the final of the Banff Curling Classic, ATB Curling Classic, so we know they love to battle from behind. I don't know if they love it, but they're good at it, and as you can tell here again, they've really switched gears, and they were down three, and now they're right back in it, and that pedal is completely to the floor right now. All offense, really putting pressure on Team Thomas. Really shows the resilience of Team Hardy.
Yeah, thanks, Mike. They're definitely always in it until the last rock, and they have a lot of grit, this team.
No! No! Gotta stop! Right off. Nice shot.
Nice throw. There you go. Another center guard. Well, they're going to try and run something straight back here and make some rocks go away. No other options, really. Got to remove something, because even that intern draw is extremely tough with that yellow corner guard over there.
Yeah.
To score. I don't even know if they can get through that hole with the amount of curl we're getting.
This is Charlie Thomas, though. You'd expect him to be quite close on a run back.
Charlie had a year there where he was sparring for Brad Guzzu on the slam scene.
Well,
I think he even went on and won a slam with Mark Nicholas.
Yes!
And it's perfect.
And there you go. Heather, I think you drinks your own team there.
Well,
I'm just saying.
Shot, Charlie. Attaboy. Great throw.
I've seen Charlie make a lot of runbacks.
Thanks.
Shot. Can't throw it any better than that one.
No.
Same ice then, probably, eh?
Yeah.
Now they got to be completely buried here. Can't poke out at all. Might leave a double for two. Like, two shots could change things around here. If anything, they probably want to just half bury on the center line side of that yellow. Don't want to over curl here. Be interested to see if Charlie plays it again, if it's dead buried. I doubt it, but you never know.
Line's great, all you. Got room. Josh.
Got to tuck a piece of this for sure.
Hard. All the way. Hard. Keep going. Far as it goes.
Okay.
Yeah, great throw. Well, there you have it. The force is on right now. They're going to have to draw the 4-foot against two to score their one. Hardy will be happy with the result of this end for sure, to get the hammer back going to six.
Nice.
Yeah, I think it's the same, hey?
At this point, both teams 14, are happy, right? Hardy's happy with the force, and right now Charlie's happy he's got a piece of the forefoot for one.
Yeah, this game's big about a momentum, so scoring one here is definitely huge to get the lead again.
Line's nice. All you guys. Sweep your tee.
Looks pretty good here. 15 seconds.
Yep. Keep it sliding.
Great throw. Well, the old skipper came, bailed them out there. Thomas with a run back triple on his first one and then draws the button for his one. So I think
really
the rest of Team Thomas
here,
should be thanking the skip after that end.
Keep everything above tee, pretty good.
The one corner worked pretty good.
Yeah.
Made him think all end.
Speed's so great.
Yeah.
I don't think it slowed down much yet.
Yeah, that was 14. Yeah. Heavy clean the whole way.
Yeah. Charlie's times are a bit higher, too.
Yeah.
Yours is 15.4, his is 14.8.
Yeah, we do sweep chairs quite a bit.
Yeah.
Like, if we didn't sweep that, it probably would have been.
Okay, well, Charlie's probably going to go. You might even see him go top four here, hoping that Hardy actually hits it. But I think the call will be top four, and then decision for Hardy. But we've seen they're probably going to go corner guard, knowing it's an even end. Is that what you tell them there, coach, if you had a timeout?
Yeah, well,
okay.
They'll definitely
want
to score here in six.
Yeah, go, Brock.
Thomas is throwing the center guard here.
Line's good. It's good. Yeah,
shut
up, Matt. A little bit.
Do I know?
Okay.
I might have thrown top four, being up one, going to six. But
I would have too.
Yeah. But I make every shot here from behind the glass.
Of course.
You know, it's a lot easier back here.
Little down.
This too. I too.
You gotta go with this rock.
We'll have to see if this corner guard comes into play, Mike. This is what Thomas did last end and never got an opportunity to use it.
That's right. But it is the exact thing that Hardy did on the fourth end, and it generated three, so.
You're right.
Really, at the end of the day, all strategy is good if you make all your shots. Keys to execute. Make eight shots and you'll probably do okay.
One only. Yep. Where? One only.
Whoa. Back eight.
Looks heavy. Looks really heavy.
Man, this is like deja vu all over again, Heather.
A little bit, although Curtis won't be happy with the placement of his first corner guard there. Yeah. It choked off the outturn come around, and it's a little higher than he would have wanted.
That rock might be in the exact spot it was in four.
Just top 12.
Top 12, top 8.
Top 8. We can go top 4.
Yep. Yeah, hard. Yep.
Well, top 8, just like they called it. So maybe tell our viewers at home what's the responsibility of the sweepers there. Who calls line? Who calls weight? And who sweeps in that situation?
Yeah, so the inside sweeper is primarily your workhorse in that situation. So their job is to keep that rock moving. The outside sweeper is judging the weight. And the two of them talk to each other, of course.
The speed's still good here, eh?
And then it's up to Jeremy to call the switch on our team, whether or not we needed that rock to curl a little bit more, and then the outside sweeper moves in to be closest to the rock.
There you go. That's the way most teams should be doing. I know you have recreational curlers at home that are listening up. Definitely have. When we are allowed to have two sweepers again, I know at our recreational leagues we're one sweeper because we're physically distancing here. These teams are cohort teams, so they designate themselves as a cohort early in the season, and which means they're probably not playing with any other teams as that are cohorts right now. So. But when we are allowed two sweepers again all the time, the one closest to the rock is doing all the work, and the other person should be really communicating the weight. And even with the one sweeper, well, the trailer that's not allowed to sweep should be communicating the weight to the skip. Without that communication, the skip really doesn't know what to call or doesn't know where the rock's going to end up. So that's really important that you never see happen at the recreational level. Not as much as it should, anyway.
Yeah, especially now that we're all wearing... Now that we're all wearing masks, it's more difficult to sweep hard and call weight. So use that second guy for sure.
That or straight peel, but this is not bad. You got it. Yeah. We're T line.
T back four. T. T.
Going around the corner here, trying to sit two, or even first and
Wait's
third.
Wait's perfect. T-line back.
Might poke out the other side, that guard's so high.
Good.
You're right, Mike.
Oh, it doesn't straight jam.
Yeah, so they recognize that yellow-red probably makes contact with that other yellow at the back eight right now. That's why they're trying to bring the play over to the corner.
Yeah, board weight, I think. Yeah, I'll be. I think you want to roll like way under.
So they did poke out so much that they're going to... play a board weight hit, get to the inside, and we can only probably see 7/8 from back here. That's
yeah.
But when the guard's that high, they'll get the late finish.
You might see Matt Ing carve this in too.
Maddie.
Got a little full on his out of his hand.
Okay, that's okay. That's fine. I don't know. He threw that really nice.
Well,
didn't move as much as I thought.
Expect a little more curl out there.
If you can tap it on the inside, you're golden. Yeah. Not that much, I don't think. Like, the main thing is over-curling the yellow. So T-line, I think.
A little bit of communication down there. Kyler gives lots of input when it comes to strategy out there. Is that the plan of the team? They've played together for so long, obviously. They 100% respect and trust each other. But great communication for sure.
Well, absolutely. And when you were learning about strategy around the kitchen table from the best, you might as well use that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Shannon knows a little bit about the game. We had her last week. It was great. She gave a lot of insight and great. Oh, just rubbed on that guard. Well, that might have been the worst case scenario there, just because now they might try this double and sit four.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, it's pretty naturally thin. Quarter? Yeah.
Is that the call or?
I guess so, because if you leave it like right there, then that accesses to there, right? Yeah, like even if he has a double off this, he's still only full 12, and he's going to be open. Okay. Yeah, you can maybe make it off the back of the
seven. What turn do you want, Brock?
In? I don't know. I think
you want to
throw peel? Like, I don't
do
think
you want
to throw
peel? Or...
Okay.
Should be straight, eh?
Because anything off the yellow right now is a jam. So. Okay, you got it. What?
Well, they're going to try the double, like we said here. Pretty thin.
Yeah, you got it.
Big shot here. This is.
Yeah, you're already doing that. It's fine. You can roll it right here. It's pretty good, actually. Okay. Bad.
That worked out okay. Hit it definitely a little too thick.
Okay, rock. It's okay. That's tough with the intern, kids. Intern, you're always going to be a little wide, right?
It's weird, but same way as Josh on the nose.
Oh, that's so risky. Could be there with the curl.
I think one thing you've already noticed with this team, Mike, is they like to talk about all of their options before, which I really appreciate. They like to hear everything and then make the best decision.
So this goes right through here.
Yeah, that's great. They got to analyze everything, especially when you're playing teams such a high caliber. You can't leave them anything. You got to expect them to make all shots.
That way, right?
Yeah, I think you could go wide around it, but you're going to sit wide open. If you rolled there, it's not terrible.
Yeah. I'm thinking big roll, though. Yep, let's do it.
Okay, they're going to try and hit and roll frozen on that one back eight, which would be good because obviously Team Thomas is going to run one of those yellows into the red on the top four, but if they do stick it in there and this is frozen to the back yellow, okay. Team Hardy will probably still be
shot.
Let's
roll it,
Meg. It's important to roll to the right spot here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then. Yeah. Whoa! Hard!
Wow, looks real good.
Sweep.
Is it good?
It's just in the hole, Mike.
It's in the hole, but is the yellow angle slash get both reds?
They probably still maybe have an angle on their yellow red, but that
would
wait
for this.
One.
Like, I think you have to play normal, don't you?
Well, they're trying to hit the hole here and make sure this red goes away.
What intern hit
right
roll?
In between on the roll there.
Hit roll, okay. What way?
Normal.
Okay.
Is that too much?
Wow.
Kind of weight? You don't have a ton of room.
Normal? Okay. You got it. Normal?
Yeah.
I think you have to get the roll.
Whoa. Close. Yep.
Yes.
It's real close. Hard. Hard.
Oh,
gotta go really hard.
Oh man.
See that pretty good.
Okay.
Okay, well, there's still that one lonely red in there.
Yeah, can I freeze and be shot? I think so. They are playing this right away here. I just don't know what we do after they make it because it's two shots to remove.
Well, can they go wide around it and catch the side of the four first?
At least it's good pressure if we go over there, but.
Like, he's got a taper to stick there.
Hit it anywhere, right? Like, anywhere thin you make.
Yeah.
Actually, you could come off the bottom of the seven, but. If we go there, he puts that in there, then what do we do? Sure. Okay. Let's go off that. Okay,
well, they're trying to go in here, but they're saying it might be hard to nut it in there, which means it's hard to plant it right on the nose and have the yellow not spin off.
Good spot, right?
When Thomas comes up and throws the angle raise into the red that's shot.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't mind looking at coming all the way around those two yellows to the side of the four, maybe sit two that way.
Josh a bit. Josh! Line's good! Josh! Hard! Line's good!
Gotta go hard for Wade here. Hard, gotta go hard for Wade and line. Well, just a little light on that one.
Yeah, that outside one.
Won't be happy with that result.
Jam.
No, that was a missed opportunity.
I don't think so. Like, I think you're hitting it right there.
I'm just worried that this one jams.
I know, and I think that it jams on that, and then we might only be lying this, and they have that one.
Well, they're overlapped, so the only thing I'm worried about is if the upper goes this way, it might jam on the back one. So, like, they just got to figure out which one.
I think we play this one. It's super thin.
Because the problem is with
really
with Brock's last one, we moved that yellow over, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, they don't want it any thick.
Like, we
can't worried
go too right. Actually,
jam
on the back
yellow?
Of
if we go that way and our top two are there, even if it jams, our top two might still be shot. Like, that back yellow might kind of be in the 12 foot now. Yeah, whichever. Like, they can see the angles, so.
I think if you just hit this really thin, I don't know. You guys see something else?
Well, so if you hit the one on the right, is it going to jam on the back?
I think so. I think there's a lot more that can go really bad from that.
Okay.
So this, I think we can easily, like, sit three around. I know that wouldn't be ideal, but.
No, that's, yeah.
Well, there you go.
Should
run
that's
really why they
straight.
Chose the
yeah,
back
no, that's
one.
Good.
So they're trying to angle this yellow into the red and sit right there. It's real thin. It is there.
Whoa. Yep. Yes! Nice.
Oh, it did touch that one over there.
Hey, shot. That's good.
Still pretty good.
Yeah, good, Charlie. Nice shot.
Mike, is yellow sitting too?
Whoa. You're throwing me.
You go there and hold the rest on the seven. Huh.
Right. What do we think, crew? Is yellow sitting too? Oh, we're getting somebody stepping up on stepping out there, saying it's yellow
like
sitting second shot as well.
He draws.
Yeah, we're gonna say yellow sitting too, Heather.
Well, if he overrolls, it's a double for two.
It's definitely a big point, though. You're right.
Third.
Okay.
Confirmation.
Very.
Well, I don't say it unless I know for sure.
Or hit and roll.
We usually tell them, forget the measure. We'll just tell
I
you what it is.
I think we draw. Yeah.
And then if we do this, he tries to hit and roll, or we
Yeah. And if he knows it's, then we have a double. He either hits and rolls or makes one perfect, because he can sit two, right?
If we do this, he might just stop that.
You ever consider coming back and tapping that and sitting second and third?
Is it the call?
Oh, dead eye, Deb McLaren said, of course it's yellow sitting too. Deb is only correct 49 out of 50 times, though, just to let you know. She is wrong the one time. This could be it.
Right, and that's the play. Yeah.
Right, yeah, that's probably safer, and we can get our two that way. Just
what if you come back and hit that one at the back? It's a shot. I mean, it would be tough deuce, but... If you go to roll under, they play the tap, you might have a double for two.
Yeah. I don't mind that call. I don't mind this call.
Hitting and rolling out a little bit.
Yeah. Get as close to nose.
Yeah, they're hoping right now they get left a double to score, that bring that other Brock into play.
Or at least keep the scoring area open enough.
You only did up. Dilemma with this, like you heard, if they roll out a little too far, then there's a free draw for Thomas to go in top button. And then you might be left with a run back triple for two. Got to stick around here with your shooting, though. It's important. This one's way out there.
We can't.
Hard.
We're on this. Kurt. We were going to just tick it if we didn't do that.
So Brock can't sweep his rock there, even though he wanted to come out. Even though it is his rock, he's not allowed to come into the house when the other team's there.
I mean, definitely got to throw that intern.
That's correct.
Intern right to full four.
Well, just got a little full on that track down there.
Yeah,
that guard's over a bit, but I think that's close.
Well.
So our side yellow is above the tee?
It's right on it.
Right on the tee. Okay, so we want to be just like full top four.
Yeah, we can be on the tee. I can't see him playing like off of that.
Okay.
I can't.
So we can be like top button is what you want?
Yeah.
Okay.
So there you go. Top button, top four. If they slide behind the tee line, they think that Hardy will play the double off the other one.
Because we were what, top
first
four?
Point.
Yeah.
It was right tee.
Yeah, we swept it the whole way. So you can be a foot or a couple feet more. Yeah. But
see if we can get a time on this one. I don't think the ice has changed here, so.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Really nice is always a good comment for the skip to hear.
It's all there right now. Stay close. Wade, feel good. Stay close. It looks close. Go.
15.
Come on. I get 8 foot cutting.
Jesus Christ.
Well, the sweepers thought it was there, but it just came up a little light.
Here, so this is going to look very easy. Yeah, but if we go in between, we're going to miss it.
Right.
We're going to go over here, right?
Right.
We got to choose.
I'm right behind the hack, Mike, and you can only see a sliver of this yellow.
Okay.
But the guard is high.
And the double is there for two. I'd be happy to take their single right now, but if they do happen to roll over and touch that yellow.
Mm-hmm. This looks like a Cooey-esque board weight double to me.
I think so. Or never mind Cooey. We're going Hardy-esque.
I mean Cooey to win the Briar, but
Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, touch the yellow back there. It's definitely too yellow now because.
Jer, this is pretty dumb. Let's just play hack. Hack.
There you go. One point here is important.
Big, I kind of like to wish that Jeremy would go back down there and reset, but we'll see. Maybe it makes no difference.
Yep. Whoa. Yep. Hard Josh.
Gotta go real hard.
Hard Josh. Go hard. Keep going. Three.
Well, they wanted to jump it earlier, and then they got off, and it just rubbed on the top guard. Unfortunately, to give up a steal of three.
Good boys. Good hit. What? We made Charlie's laugh when he probably would have won. Yeah. Took on.
Another comment that if they had Charlie had made his last one perfect, they might not have tried that shot. But I didn't like the switch while he was in the hack. I don't know what you think about that, Coach, but I think once you're down here, you got to stick with the shot. If you'd want to change it, you should probably head back down there, reset, take the right ice. And what would you think of that, Coach?
Well, fair enough, Mike, and after you miss it, absolutely.
It's easy to say it when you miss, I know.
Yeah, but you said it beforehand, and I don't disagree.
I just think it's, we always try and teach teams if you're better off to, once you get in the hack, you go with the shot. You get two shots in your mind, the mind is a simple thing. Keep it pretty basic.
Yeah.
Well, that was a big three-pointer
right
here.
That normal way hit, for sure. I think so. I think it is.
We know Hardy never gives up, though, so this game is far from over yet. They're going to try and go hard to generate their three right back here.
Definitely there.
I think so, yep.
I shouldn't say that.
Yep. They're on its own. You sure?
Yeah. Oh. It's there.
Yeah, it's just really coming down. We gotta watch
just
every
like
rock.
Getting real flat here.
There you go. They think the weight's coming off a little
just
bit.
Just go intern. Let's stack them.
What's we notice from some of the top teams in the past, they sweep them early, hold them out there, and then let them fudge up at the end. But, you know, if you wait for it to start curling, like we said, it's really hard to get it moving again. That rock's been short probably four times this game, though. Might want to make note of that.
We'll go another one.
When you're back on this sheet for the final.
Really gotta go.
Sweeping. Chop.
Now it looks like they're going to stack him on the side there.
Mm-hmm. Definitely time for two corners.
Yeah, same throw.
Line's okay.
Yeah, keep an eye on it though.
Where?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
We're gonna be really close to this.
So right
really
beside
close
it.
To this.
Right beside it.
Okay, I think we're on this. Yep.
Yep.
Line. I don't know what we're gonna do here. I think just freeze it.
Yeah, nice, Matt. Shot.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, Aaron's looking for an update again. I guess
three
we get
feet.
Focused on the one game here and forget what's going on, but. I know on sheet one we have Sturmey with a 6-2 lead after five ends of play. That is correct. They're only in the sixth end over there, so a little behind over Team Jake's.
Mm-hmm. Good three.
On team
three.
Sheet four, it looks like
three,
we've
four.
Got Team King.
Yeah.
And Vavrick.
Yeah,
and Vavrick
hard
must have
by.
Just scored, but I'm not
hard
sure how many. And Glenn Kennedy is up three with Hammer on
it.
Libis.
In the seventh end. Not looking good over
nice
there for
shot.
Team Libis.
Good shot.
So on tight? Is that tight or in? Yeah, either one.
So you got your two corner
yeah.
jars stacked on the same
yeah.
side there.
It's definitely getting a little heavy.
Lots of line. Line's perfect.
Line's good.
Line's perfect.
Line's good.
Line's good, guys. Line's perfect. Looks okay. Looks like it's sliding okay.
Line's good.
Easy.
Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going.
Yep,
keep going.
Little finish. Yep. Cross center.
Yeah, nice sweep, guys.
Great shot. Good sweep.
Yeah, great sweep.
I don't know. I got 16 on that one. Heather said it slid pretty good. Maybe it's just that first rock there. They're getting a little fooled. Like
yep.
we said, it's been short yep. both four times this game.
Third rock in the path as well.
That's correct, yeah.
I think this is at least a double here, Mike. I don't know if the triple's there.
Nice shot.
Great throw, made it, no problem. Now got lots of guards up in front to work with.
Yep. Like they can't really come around these.
I like the peel, I think. Peel the top one.
I don't know. Do you want, can you
we're
come
up
here for
to lots of viewers here today, Gruno.
Yeah, I think we kind of need to figure out how we want to play this. Like we're up, right? We want to limit them to two. Yeah, it's only two ends left.
Just building as the weekend goes along here. Wait till we get to the final. We'll at least
yeah,
be
so
at 15,000.
Like, yeah, I know. They can't get around these, though. Like, I don't know.
Well, I
hello from New Zealand. My old buddy Jamie Chisholm tuning in.
Like, it's hard for them to get this way. Yeah.
Great curler himself over there
right,
playing in New Zealand
like
now.
Like, Hearthstone's pretty safe there.
Yeah.
Of course, Jamie, an old curler well, here from the Oak Tokes Curling
like
Club. His dad and his brother
have,
are still members
okay, I don't
here.
Mind just straight peeling right now.
I don't know what season is it over in New Zealand. Do we know that right now? Is it summertime?
Yeah, it'd be getting warm.
It's pretty summer all the time, pretty much over there. Like.
I also don't.
I don't know how they curl over there.
Call the game for them, you know, but like.
They find a way. I know I've seen pictures of him heading to the curling rink in his shorts. Just like that lady in Mexico there. We really don't care about hearing from these people when it's warm. It's supposed to snow here today, so thanks,
whoa,
everybody.
Whoa.
It's just clean.
Whoa.
Well, you're going to see run wrapped around back eight here, it looks like.
See you, Josh. Yeah, back 12. You got it, Josh.
They're going to use that yellow as a guard that's up there top eight right
now.
Yeah.
We're T-line.
T-back four. Back four.
Back eight.
Wait, good.
Yeah, go. We got to be back 12.
That's a great throw. Good. Perfect
sweeping.
Spot. Well, we might see another peel of the guards here. Doesn't want to run it into his yellow, though. Real little risky here if you get rid of that yellow.
Can we get off the back of that red?
I know,
that's my worry. Yeah, okay.
You'll see Hardy come around the corner. So just a straight peel here. Make sure anybody out there watching subscribes to the Okotos Curling Club YouTube page.
Good, clean.
You'll be able to get updates whenever we're running some live streaming. We've got a big event next weekend here with a ladies tour event.
Bro.
Pretty much Canada Cup field, other than maybe Tracy Fleury and a few others. But we got names like Jennifer Jones, Rachel Holman, Carrie Anderson, Scheidegger, Walker, Rock.
Okay.
It's the place to be next weekend, Heather.
Absolutely, Mike.
You know, if you weren't in Penticton, you could come commentate again. Are you going to Penticton next weekend?
I'm not, no.
Whoa. Write her down, Gruno.
Let her.
She's free.
Whoa! Wait only! Kurt!
Going hard to go around the corner here. Great location, great spot. Sitting two. That's right, you heard it. Sitting two.
Kind of want to run it, don't we? Okay.
Donna Red's building up in the house here.
Yeah, and to JD's point, if you don't run this, I think it's kind of a gimme deuce for Hardy, but, you know, Thomas is up four. They're okay with giving up two here.
Yeah. Get better you want.
Got another final over on sheet five. Looks like Team Kennedy is moving on the C, and Team Libis has been eliminated.
Whoa. Yep.
Okay. Hey. Got.
Well, do you like another corner, or are they going to split the house and sit three?
Well, I guess we're going to.
I think on your third, second rock, it's time to put another one in the rings, but
we'll it's not going to be shot, but make it perfect.
I agree. If they put one frozen over there, there's not really an easy double. Yeah. This other double is real thin. And. So,
only other thing I see is right here.
Yeah, and then it might just, he just slams that in.
Okay, let's do that then.
Yeah, I like the call here.
Yep, I agree. Not that it matters, but I agree.
First rock, I'll give you 2 feet. I don't think anyone's running here yet.
You want to be above that yellow? Or
I want to freeze it, but he's giving me too much ice right now. Hair less ice, commit to the freeze, yeah. Let's do it.
Got room. Whoa, not curling. Line's good. Whoa. Go then, go then. Yep.
No, no, not our yellow.
Josh, if you can. Josh.
Perfect, exactly where they wanted it, Heather.
Yeah, two great draws there from Kyler. Really yeah. needed those.
Yeah, like I was thinking, like the guard he peeled, like run the red.
Yeah, I don't think yeah. he's hitting all
yeah.
here. He does a double draw too.
Yeah, as long as he's not wide and jams on our yellow.
Yeah, rolling like rolling right here is pretty good. Yeah. yeah, the thing is, like, yes, that's perfect, but
like just peeling
the odds
is
of you doing that are much higher, higher, right?
Okay,
three in the house, right?
Just control. But.
Well, they're trying to roll way over the side of the eight, and everybody
little,
at home probably wonders
like
why they don't just roll right to the right behind
like,
the yellow,
like,
but they know they'll leave an easy
yeah.
double for
like,
Jeremy to sit three. And if they happen to miss their
yeah,
double on
yeah,
the last
exactly.
shot, then it'll be an easy three to
yeah,
get right back
sure
in the game.
Make sure we're out counting that, that left one for sure.
I think we want a big roll. I don't think we want to go right behind it.
Don't. No, I think because I think if we just even if we knows it, we're sitting, we're out, at least out counting that side one.
We just know that. Yeah, the only reason that we kind of like the roll is that then they hit it, we have a double, easy
yeah.
double, right?
No, no, I think that's best, but like, yeah.
yeah,
nose is still not a bad option too.
But honestly, we roll right behind it and he makes the double, at least a lot of straight back double.
Yeah.
Or, yeah. Okay, just control.
Really well shot out there from Charlie, thinking two shots ahead.
Yeah, exactly, they got...
it's good.
Trying to roll way over here.
Yep.
Sitting first and third, you'll probably be happy.
That was plan B and
plan B.
Pretty good.
Nice, Charlie. Beauty.
Jeez. I must just be doing something to that because that's unnatural.
Yeah, that curl. That's exactly what we call it.
Calculated.
Perfect.
Not quite, but they'll
then
take it.
You got an easy drop, too. I don't know. Like, you just hope he ever makes a play on it. Yeah. It hope he jams that three or make a play on this. Yeah.
Well, I'll try and hit and roll behind this little rock here at the top of the eight.
Yeah, slightly higher percentage shot than the double.
Yep. Hard.
Going hard for line here.
Hard. Hard, Josh. Hard, Josh.
Hard to get
all
by.
Right.
Gotta go
keep
hard
going,
to get
bud.
By.
Hard. Sweet.
Just stuck around over there. No, looks like it's just outside the rings.
Peel it over the top.
Yeah, it's peel. Okay.
Strong peel here. Nose hit should do.
Thank you.
Just trying to play the double here, maybe blank, keep the hammer, I'm not sure. It's kind of.
Yeah. It's kind of your only chance.
Yeah.
Whoa! Kurt!
Watch out for the jam at the back.
Oh.
Did it stick there?
No, oh, there you go. That's what I love about curling.
What do you guys want to do?
Never a doubt. Team Thomas said it was going out. Don't worry about us.
I don't even think we can get four and tied in bait.
Well, that end was pretty good. that's the only thing keeping me going, yeah.
I don't know if we're going to ever get more than three.
Yeah.
It's up to you guys.
Let's play it super quick.
Sure.
That was a really good end.
Good.
Okay.
Looks like they're going to try and play the last end.
Yeah. Just throw them both. All of them through, eh?
Yeah, they have a break either way, right? And
just peel them.
Yeah, they go right to a C qualifier after this, so.
Yeah, and they've had some opportunities and
want to
leave this game feeling good.
Yeah.
Shake early. just two quick guards and shake early if you have to. See.
They want to be respectful of Team Thomas, of course. But
yeah, exactly.
They don't play
Team Thomas
for a long time, so it's not rude.
I love them thinking about that, though. You get, you know, it's not really a practice time. They're going to throw a couple rocks up. They got to push them back there anyway,
yeah,
and then they'll shake early here. And they know Team Thomas doesn't have to play again now till tonight.
Tomorrow?
Or tomorrow.
It's only Saturday, Mike.
That's right, but they're only in a qualifier tomorrow. The qualifiers are tonight, or the quarterfinals are
good
tonight.
One, two. Let's
is that
go
correct?
Three, if you don't
the quarterfinals are at 8:30 tonight, yeah.
We're tight.
Okay.
So, semi-final, final tomorrow.
Okay, if that goes in, we're done.
Unless I'm completely wrong, but...
I trust you.
I didn't do the draw, actually, to be honest with you. So, but I remember looking at it a few times. There were four draws today, so quarterfinals would...
The little mixed double. I was just gonna
quarterfinals
say,
tonight.
And heavy hack the board.
Semi-finals and finals tomorrow.
Probably. Yeah, mm-hmm.
Heavy hack the board. Hit a corner of it.
You mixed doubles, Matty?
Yeah.
This is the mixed doubles the corner guard tick. I think we're going to see this more and more with the five rock rule.
Yeah. Yeah, it's all there. Yep,
close.
Yep. Good one.
Good one.
Good
one. Better double check that playoffs. I'm starting to question myself now. Yeah, we're just going to put it up on our website right away.
I think it still helps us if we get it over there, doesn't it?
The playoffs have been sent out to the teams in the original draws.
We'll just throw the same matches through, like, heavy hack.
What did you throw? Is it the same he said? Okay.
Whoa. Close. Whoa.
Matt. Okay, good try.
You got it, Josh.
Saturday. There you go.
Yeah.
Yep. Saturday tonight at 7. The original draw sent out with the playoffs. Glad you had a copy of that, Heather. I forgot it's only Saturday for a while, and then it could be Friday. I mean, days are just going together right now.
Yeah, you're working hard out here, putting in more hours than anybody else, but we appreciate it.
Well, I suspect if this doesn't stop, then you're going to see some broom tapping here. Oh, just hung on at the back.
Yep. Clean. Clean. Yep. Good.
Ah, it's good.
You got it. Sure, 1 foot. One foot less.
Back eight. Back eight.
Well, they're going to try and bury four rocks behind this one corner guard.
Back four.
We did see it once almost happen back at the Olympic trials where Ross Howard buried a bunch of rocks behind a corner guard on John Morris, I believe it was, at the trials for the 2006 Olympics, I think it was. Well, it was actually Brad Guju, but of course skipped by Russ Howard.
Yeah. Yes, yes!
Buried three rocks behind one corner guard, I think, to win the game.
Well, I don't know.
Or win one of those games during that trials. Okay. Oh, there you go. Great shot.
Shot.
Good.
A bit heavy.
This one looks heavy.
Good game, boy.
Well, there you have it. We've normally see handshakes, but due to COVID, we're broom taps. And that is your final. Team Thomas has run Team Hardy out of rocks, so your final is 8-4. Great back and forth battle, and we will see Hardy back on the ice later this afternoon for a C qualifier game, and I'm sure we'll see them in the playoffs because they are definitely one of the favorites here. And for Team Thomas, they now get a chance to wait till tonight and get ready for the quarterfinal action, see who they play, but they're probably really excited they've qualified. And Heather, thank you very much for participating today. I mean, your expertise doesn't go on, it goes unmatched with anybody. Well, John Dunn was here yesterday, but you know, between you and him, it was great insight, especially for to see Team Hardy. And we hope to get you back on. And to all the viewers out there, thanks for tuning in, and we're back on at 12 o'clock.
Thanks,
we'll see
you
all then.
Mike.
Thanks, Heather.
Who would have thunk it?